little bit of carpool karaoke.
Cute.
And I'm gonna be picking a song for William to sing.
Mama.
A voice.
Just the man. The inside is. Pulled my out, now he's dead.
And good morning. First off, my voice is shot. I'm sick. I've been sick for like a week and I'm not getting over it anytime soon, but you know, we got some medicine and we're just gonna power through it. But yeah, just ignore my scratchy voice. Today we're going to LA. I'm so excited because I'm meeting with manufacturers. I'm starting up a new brand. I haven't really talked about this really at all with many people, and especially not on my social media, but I definitely want to keep you guys in the loop, and I want to document this process and kind of answer questions as I go along of what I'm doing, because I know there's probably a lot of you out there that want to start your own brand, and getting stuff manufactured is totally different than what I used to do. I used to have a store, but I would sew everything in my room. So that was just like me, myself, and I, whereas now I'm going to be going through someone. I'm not sewing anything at all. And it's just gonna be crazy. So I've picked two manufacturers that I wanna meet up with in LA, and I'm going down there up there today because I live in San Diego, and we're just gonna do it, and I'm gonna try to document as much as I can. I don't know if I'll be able to like full on like bring you guys inside the meetings. I definitely am not gonna do that, but I'll show you as much as I can of my LA trip. I'll be there probably until after traffic, so I'll probably be there until after dinner. And I'm about to go to my boyfriend's warehouse. He does like clothes too. He has a warehouse for his store. But you're like, warehouse? But I'm about to go to his warehouse. I'm gonna leave my car there, and then we're gonna take his car to LA. So I'll keep y'all updated. What I'm bringing to LA to meet with these manufacturers are like samples of fabrics that I like. So I just went and bought like, if I liked like a pair of sweatpants and I liked the fabric, I'm gonna bring those. I'm gonna bring them all the different fabrics that I found that I like that I wanna use in my brand. I'm also bringing them sketches of what I want to make and kind of like a brand board, as well as a timeline of when I'm looking to get these things made, and pricing for like wholesale. So I'm looking, let's say it's, like I said, a pair of sweatpants. I'll be like, okay, I'm going to retail them at this. So I'm looking to get them at this price. And that's kind of what we're doing. Like I said, it's two meetings. I'm meeting one manufacturer at 1 p.m. and the next one at 2:30, and they're like less than a mile away from each other, which is great because driving in LA is not fun, especially in the fashion district. If you guys have ever been in the fashion district, it's like, yeah, just anywhere in LA, no, you don't want to do that. So we're just gonna park, walk around, we're gonna go to the meetings, you know, get some food, whatever, and I will keep y'all in the loop. Okay, so thanks for watching. Here with William.
Hi everyone.
Say hi to all the people.
Hi all the people.
All my 92 subscribers. So many people. We are about to leave to go to LA. Babe, I'm literally just a head. Like with the black background, I just look like a head. And we're probably gonna get something to eat. Or, oh, we have some snacks, I don't know. Do you wanna stop or do you wanna just go?
I know, you guess.
Gonna get some gas and get on with it. Well, I got my hoodie on. It is cold AF, and we are about to get on our way. Okay, so we got our Starbucks. We got our jacket, we're good to go. I'm just so ready to go to LA. I'm just such a YouTuber now. I'm just gonna move to LA. Okay. So we're gonna do a little bit of carpool karaoke. And I'm gonna be picking a song for William to sing.
Mama. Just the man. The inside is. Pulled my out, now he's dead.
Cut. Y'all, it is raining.
there are the boobs. We call them the boobs. I don't know what they really are, but they look like two titties. So yeah, awesome. And randomly, it's perfect weather now, so that's cool. That was a rough 10 minutes of rain. So Will has to poop.
Fuck off, it's you, that's the shit.
So we found a Target. Cause I don't want to go in a gas station. Like, no. I need at least a Target. Maybe like a Vons or something, you know. So just a quick little pit stop. We're in LA and it is rainy again. Some bipolar weather, you guys. I don't really know what to expect. I don't know if this is a whole like factory where they manufacture everything. I'm actually meeting two manufacturers, but I don't know if this is just their office or their whole factory or, you know, whatever. So we'll see. I'll show you guys as soon as we get there and we figure it out. What? Yeah, let me get your backpack. Fuck. Okay guys, so it's raining and we're here in LA and here is the view. We're about to go down and meet these manufacturers. So we'll see. It's gonna be in that building right there. We just gotta cross the road. It's a little bit cold, but we're doing okay. When we get inside, I'm gonna take this off so I look more professional. Okay guys, hello. I'm in the bathroom at the manufacturing place. Basically, it's just a huge, like, huge building with a bunch of different offices and stuff. And this isn't where they're actually manufacturing, I don't think. But I'm not sure. But where I'm meeting in is just like a little office building. I'll show you guys a little bit. So yeah, you wouldn't really think there's much going on in here, and then you just open the door and there's like a whole office, or I'll show you over here. They have people like sewing stuff, but this isn't the one that I'm meeting in right now. So we are about to meet with the second manufacturer. And first meeting went good, but it's just gonna be so expensive. So we'll see. I'm thinking it's gonna be the same pricing for the second manufacturer, but we'll see what they say and I'll keep y'all updated. Versus Will's little tiny baby bowl. I'm going in.
Thank you.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. We got some mochi dippers. Okay, how is it? Try it out. What do we got? Chocolate? What was the sauce?
White chocolate.
White chocolate, sprinkles, chocolate.
Feel me eat it.
Yeah. First bite, first impression. Oh wow. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh wow. Ew. Regurgitated it. How is it? It's good. I'm gonna do matcha with that and the sprinkles. He wants a picture of himself. You don't want one of both of us? The answer to that was a no. Down here on a Santee Alley. No, I'm gonna pass on a gun. I don't know why they were selling a gun. Very suspicious. A lot of things. Very interesting.
Thank you.
don't know what I feel about this. Okay, so we're about to go back to the car and head home. Today was a successful day. And oh my god, he's annoying, but
that's a successful
day. And it's time for some traffic. Woohoo! So exciting.
12 seconds later. 3 days later. 3:28 a.m.
Hey guys, so I got home and I realized that like half of the video just wasn't finished. Like I tried to edit the video and I realized I hadn't like explained anything that happened at the second manufacturer, and I didn't really give like an overview or like an ending. So I'm now getting around to filming it, even though it's like 2 weeks later. My hair is even like a different color than in the video. This was like before Thanksgiving when I went to LA, and then Thanksgiving came around and I went to Fresno for a week. That's where I'm from. And it just was really busy. So finally I'm getting around to finishing this video. And yeah, so I'm gonna do my best to explain where I left off like 2 weeks ago when I was in LA. So basically just like I'm gonna give a little overview. Like I said, I'm starting a new brand. I'm gonna make a whole nother video about that. And I'd like to take you guys along on the whole process and like show y'all what I'm doing along the way, and hopefully like help you if you wanna start a business or, you know, stuff like that. But I went to LA to meet with manufacturers. There was two that I had talked to and kinda chosen out of all the different ones that I'd been speaking with that I thought potentially could fit my needs and like work well with me. So I set up meetings with those two. One of the meetings cost me like $150, and that was with the first manufacturer, and I didn't even end up really feeling like they vibed with me or like I could use them. So that kind of sucked, but I feel like it gave me a good like point of reference, because if I had just met with one, I wouldn't really know what was like normal, I guess. So it kind of gave me like a comparison to know that the other manufacturer was probably a better fit if I decided to go with LA. But yeah, so the first manufacturer, I think I did like talk a little bit about it throughout the video while I was there, but basically they were smaller, so like they kind of were like family owned and they had all their manufacturing in-house, so they didn't outsource any manufacturing and they didn't do their manufacturing in factories. They did it all like in the LA like high-rise, just like the back of their office that they rented. And they did work with like some big brands. I know they worked with Arizona Tea and did like some of their merch. And there were some other brands that they showed me that were really cool, and all their stuff was really good. I'm not gonna say who these manufacturers are, because I think one, if you do wanna find a manufacturer, you should have to do your own research like me. But also, it is my goal eventually to do some type of like program where I coach people or like show them how to start a business, and that's where I would probably reveal like some of my sources and things that I've found. But I don't want to just like give it up to you that easily. But if you guys do want me to make a video about how to find manufacturers and kind of like the differences and what to look for and what to ask, I definitely would be open to doing that, but gotta do your own research like me. But anyway, so this first manufacturer, basically they just didn't have the capacity to do what I needed to do cheaply, because they weren't outsourcing anything. And when I say outsourcing, I don't mean outsourcing it overseas. I just mean they weren't making their stuff in big factories, and they were using basically all their family to be doing the sewing and stuff. So that was just, oh wow, my sister got me this like texturizing spray when I was home, but it's making it a little fluffy. So the first manufacturer got the boot, but I did pay them $150, so they're $150 richer just from 30 minutes of my time. But yeah, that's not gonna work. So then I met with the second manufacturer. Luckily they were both like a 10 minute walk from each other. They were in the fashion district of LA, and this one was a guy that I think he's either one of the owners or like high up in the company. It's a smaller company, I believe. But he doesn't do like the sewing and stuff himself, whereas I think the first guy like even helped with the sewing. But he just kind of like oversees client relations. So I had been speaking with this guy via text and email and stuff, and I had reached out to their company, you know, like maybe a month before actually meeting, and we had already talked over what I needed.
But then when we met in person, it was nice because he brought samples of a brand that they had done that were really similar to what I was looking for. So I could physically see like the product and hold it and see the packaging that they did, the tags, like everything like that. And he also had price points for that product, so I can kind of compare the pricing of what I would need it at, you know, this many units and so on and so forth. So the second meeting went really well. The guy was awesome. He was super nice, helpful, and he answered all my questions, and he seemed to really know the needs of like small businesses that are just starting out rather than just trying to get the prices up or the minimums up and stuff. He seemed like flexible and able to work with someone that's just starting off. So that was really important and really awesome. I brought Will along, as you guys saw, and he was great. He was like taking notes the whole time for me. It was really sweet. So yeah, the meeting went really well. I think that they definitely, or I know that they're able to make what I need to make, but I'm just not sure if it's better for me to outsource it overseas or if I want to do it in LA. I think I do want to do it in LA, but since Will's, he has a business as well, my boyfriend, and he does women's leggings and all of his stuff is outsourced overseas. And I've just seen, you know, the prices and just how much more you're able to get for your money if you do outsource that overseas. So I'm kind of just comparing both options, and I'm trying to get samples made from Will's supplier, as well as I'm going to reach out soon to the supplier that I just met with a couple weeks ago, the one in LA I was just talking about, and I'm going to try to get some samples made from them. And then from there, once the samples are made, they can give me wholesale prices at, you know, 50 units, 100 units, 500 units. Not that I'm going to need 500 at first, but it's still nice just to know what the pricing is going to be, and then I can compare quality, compare pricing, you know, turnaround times. I'll have all that info once they know exactly what I need and once they've made that sample, and then I can kind of go from there and see like, oh, in LA, you know, maybe there's lower minimums, but it's so much more expensive that for the same price I can get, you know, 100 over in China and it's the same thing, or vice versa, like maybe the prices are almost similar and the minimums are lower in LA, so I decided to do that. And also quality is really important to me, so I just want to see what they can do and kind of how close each company can get it to what I'm envisioning in my mind. So it went well, and I think I found a manufacturer, but I gotta just, like I said, compare all those things and wait it out. It's probably gonna be another month and a half before I have all the samples done and in hand. But I'm pretty patient. I'm not trying to launch this brand until next like fall, winter, like October, November-ish, like definitely before Black Friday and Christmas of next year. So I have a lot of time, and I've just been trying to save up money. I don't have any investors. I don't really have anyone helping me. I never have in the past, even with Rolling Roses or anything. I just have been funding everything myself. So I'm just working and grinding. I am a waitress, so I'm just picking up as many shifts as I can and doing, you know, like side modeling gigs and stuff like that. So just working that hustle life. but yeah, anyways, so that is kind of my experience. It was really fun going to LA. I used to go all the time. I would do like modeling stuff, or I would have photo shoots for Rolling Roses, but I really don't go that much anymore, and it kind of made me realize like I need to go a little more. It's fun. There's a lot happening over there. And you know, there's like a lot of shows and stuff. I just feel like it's a good little easy 2-hour drive. So I definitely will be going to LA a little more, especially if I decide to work with this manufacturer, and I will take you guys along whenever I go. I'll do some vlogs or something. But if you have any questions, please just comment below. You can message me, DM me. My Instagram is just my name, @CassTorrance. I'll link everything below. And let me know if you want me to make a more in-depth video about how to find a manufacturer and also what you should be looking for. There's a lot of different types of businesses or like ways that you could launch your business. So for me, I'm trying to create an actual brand where I'm getting clothes made, but you also could launch a wholesale business where you're just reselling clothes, or you could do it like I was doing before where you're hand sewing everything. So that's all totally different stories. But if you have any questions, I'm pretty familiar with all three of those different ways of like launching your brand, and I could definitely help you. So just message me anytime, email me, DM me, send me a paper airplane. I don't care. I'll definitely get back to you and try to help the best that I can. But yeah, y'all have a great day, and I'll see ya later.